Hello everybody, welcome back to another episode of Let's Play Jurassic Park Trespasser. I'm your host, Diogen Z, and on today's episode, we'll be turning on this Cray computer system and leaving the lab, and actually moving on to the true next level. Now, what we have to do is basically poke all the buttons around this building, or around this room, in the color sequence that is shown on the poster. Now, John Hammond is going to be saying a lot of things that you won't be able to hear because the audio when I recorded it was bad and I had to junk it. So, to substitute that, I'll be playing John Hammond's memoirs, which is essentially the same thing as what he was saying, from a site called Jurassic Time. Now, you can go to this site, which is down below in the description box, and you can pick up more of John Hammond's memoirs and other interesting Trespasser audio files. Oh yes, I kind of forgot before we can start this whole thing off, we have to grab onto the switch. Enjoy.
It was in the last days of genetic recovery, and at this point, nothing was certain. Was the DNA there? Could we bring it back? Up the well? In a quiet, locked room, the extinction of species, the history of life on Earth, is being methodically reversed. It was 3 a.m. The room was strewn with soda cans, and for the 100th time, we ran the extraction sequence. As Ned retyped, the world seemed to hold its breath. And for a moment, we stood at the turning point between two great planetary eras. Million-year reign of man and the age of the dinosaurs. Dennis, what are we looking at here? All my life I've waited for something great, something extraordinary, and then discovery of the 20th century. We worked long into the night, feeling at times as if the whole of the earth had fallen away outside, leaving only the darkness, the work, the endless questioning of the past. Keyboards rattled into the early morning. Ranks of green CRT screens displayed collated genetic data. Three Cray XMPs move more data faster than any computer center in the Americas. Site B was fully centralized and computer controlled. The same design that became the Achilles heel of Jurassic Park. Diagnostics, communications, security, all ran through the computer. Accordingly, computer security was paramount, the tightest on the island. A Nobel Prize or a financial empire wait somewhere in a darkened room, in a dirty, derelict building, somewhere in the Pacific. It was the flowering of an ambition born 50 years ago. 50 years struggle come to this. When I was little, I dreamed of a time when the entire world was covered by an ancient forest. Great hunters stalked in the cool darkness among silent, huge columnar trees, oaks and sequoias.
I left home at 15 with a rather romantic idea of seeking my fortune. I remember the train ride south in my best clothes, eating an apple. The entire world before me. When I came to London, I had neither fortune or education nor connections. Nothing.
The mysterious John Hammond. Shady investor, multimillionaire, jovial mad scientist. An idea brought me awake one morning in New York. I almost didn't write it down. What if a mosquito sucked the blood of a dinosaur 100 million years ago? The insect is then covered in tree sap, which over the millennia becomes amber. The insect is preserved perfectly. But you see, and here's the clever part, wouldn't the dinosaur blood be preserved as well?